What's going on, guys? Unknown Player here, and today we're going to be rounding up all the latest Destiny news and everything going on with the game to be aware of that's happened recently. Going to be talking about the new patch that hit today for all of you wondering what's inside it, some Destiny 2 stuff, and also some other Destiny related things as well. So firstly, what's the deal with this new update that I'm sure most of you guys would have downloaded today? You have to back out to install the thing. So this is the new hotfix called 2.6.0.2 that I've mentioned in recent videos. This did some major bug fixes to Raids, Crucible, Eververse, Vendors, Quests, and also Miscellaneous. The most important thing that probably most of you all care about is the Miscellaneous one, and this is fixing the actual multiple records notifications. So that is thankfully not going to be popping up anymore, which is definitely very, very good news. So fixed an issue where viewing characters on Bungie.net or in third-party tools like Destiny Item Manager could cause some record book objectives to change and stay incorrectly, often resulting in a notification that we all know as multiple records. So thankfully, that bug has been squashed and should no longer be plaguing us. So some other things were a crash issue with the Knuckles of AR. I believe some people popping them on the template, the game would crash for some reason, so that's been fixed as well. There's also a bunch of issues where elimination trials round timers would not end, and I guess some rounds would just go on forever, so that has been fixed. Also with Eververse, there was some issue where Treasure of the Ages were not dropping and stacking completely, so that's been fixed too. And also a change that prevents duplicate rewards in the ships in Treasure of Ages. So that should be a good thing. And that probably means before, a lot of your rewards would have been hampered by getting these same ships over and over again. So now that won't be happening. And now I guess you have a better chance of getting new stuff, which is also a good thing too. They also fixed an issue with Eris not sending runes and some quest issues as well. So like I said, nothing major, just a hot fix, mainly for bugs. But the main thing is that multiple records, which is now being fixed. So I do see a lot of people asking, are Bungie planning on doing another sandbox patch or weapon balancing or any future tweaks to the sandbox that stands now? And they haven't said anything so far. They don't seem to have any kind of indication on things that are going to be fixed in the future. There's literally been nothing like, no, we want to fix it in the future or maybe in a future update. There's basically been no discussion from any developers on that front. If you ask me, it's probably doubtful we'll get any more updates for Destiny. I know it seems like Bungie are being very quiet and not doing much, but obviously they're working full force on Destiny 2 and have been for the past 2.5 years. That's why Destiny hasn't had that many updates or changes. I'm sure there's a billion problems in the Destiny 2 Crucible that are probably running rampant. So they're pretty busy working on that, and I'll bet all the QA testers are focused on Destiny 2 right now. So that is the deal with this hotfix, and it doesn't appear there's going to be a new sandbox patch anytime soon, but you never know, Bungie might do something later down the line after the Destiny 2 reveal. So speaking of which, what is new on the Destiny 2 front? Has there been any news or leaks or anything of interest? And once again, the answer is no, not really. Bungie is still being tight-lipped, and like I've said, don't expect anything for a few weeks until they start to ramp up the hype for the reveal itself. Now, in the blog post, all they said is, behind the scenes, we're rehearsing the gameplay premiere of Destiny 2. We'll set every week until it happens May 18th, which is less than a month away now. So that's what Bungie are doing, rehearsing the gameplay reveal. Now, a lot of people ask me what I think we're going to see from the actual reveal event, whether it's going to be a bunch of gameplay trailers or a demo or a pre-recorded mission or whatever else. Now, what I personally think it's going to be is the exact same thing we saw in the Destiny 1 reveal, honestly, the one you can see on screen right now. I think it's going to be a super generic, nondescript level in Earth, fighting against the Cabal with like no spoilers or major plot points. But yeah, I think this is basically what I'm expecting. Deej and a few other Bungie devs going through a level, co-op style, showing off the new stuff in Destiny and the new gameplay, see what's changed and everything else. But seeing the original Destiny 1 reveal of gameplay definitely brings back a lot of memories to me seeing Destiny 1 for the first time. So I can't wait to see Destiny 2 just like this. We don't have long to wait now, so keep your eyes peeled right here, because there'll obviously be a lot of videos to watch right here on the channel when that time comes. So the next thing I want to talk about is that there are a bunch of hidden story missions being featured in giving out legendary marks, and it's pretty strange, but luckily some keen-eyed people over on Reddit actually figured out what is causing this. So a user called Aqua Radnag actually made the post that I saw and appears to be the one to find this. But as it turns out, the daily story mission sequence is still actually running behind the scenes if you know where to look. So you probably remember before Age of Triumph, one random story mission would be the daily featured one that drops 15 legendary marks. And each day, a new random mission would be selected from the director. And then, of course, with Age of Triumph, they replaced that node with a playlist that's set on certain planets or expansions with modifiers that rotate each certain week. So as it turns out, that old daily story sequence is still actually running and still going on in the background each day. One random mission is still going to be giving out 15 legendary marks on the day of me making this video. It's currently the Paradox mission on Venus, as you can see right here. So this mission is going to give you extra marks, pretty random, and that's also featured, of course. But like I said, it's going to change every day, so depending on when you're watching this, there'll be one random mission. If you know where to find it, that'll be featured. So pretty random and strange, but that is the reason for these hidden missions being featured before anyone comes up with any conspiracy theories of why it's happening. Not sure if Bungie are aware of it or did it intentionally, probably just forgot to deactivate the old system, but that is the mystery solved of these story missions. So next up, I want to talk about a pretty interesting article that came from Game Rant recently, which is about Phil Spencer, the head of Xbox, I'm sure you guys know, talking about Destiny 2 and his hopes for the franchise going forward. So here's an interview talking about gaming trends, and he mentioned the growing trend of games lasting longer and being updated over time, specifically GTA and Minecraft, and he also said he has high anticipations for Destiny 2. Now, he also apparently has logged over 600 hours into Destiny 1, which isn't bad at all. I mean, I'm sure a lot of you guys have more than that, but considering he's also the CEO of an enormous company, he probably doesn't have much free time, so seeing as he spends a lot of it playing Destiny isn't too bad at all. Now, talking about Destiny 2, he said, Destiny 2 is going to be one of those games that I expect 5, 6, 7 years from now, people are still going to be playing, and I think it's going to be a little bit like World of Warcraft, which 10 or 15 years later, millions of people are still playing. Now, obviously, this isn't him giving some inside info that Destiny 2 is planned to last for 6 or 7 years. It's definitely just his perspective talking about how games these days tend to be long releases with updates and expansions that kind of prolong the life cycle, as opposed to one release every single year or even every other year, which seems to be less common these days. Now, I personally don't think Destiny 2 is planned to last itself for 6 or 7 years. The franchise is supposed to be 10 years, maybe beyond that. I think Bungie are already going to start working soon on Destiny 3, which I think we're probably releasing in 2020 around then. Everything Bungie have said recently kind of indicates they want to release a new game every couple of years and refresh the game with everything new they've learned from the most recent one. Obviously, the initial plan with Activision and Bungie in the contract was for a new full Destiny game every 2 years with a Taken King Comet size expansion in between, but I wouldn't be surprised if that's been changed to 3 years now to give Bungie more time. Obviously, there are a ton more studios working on Destiny with Bungie. It's not just them, so they've got a ton more manpower for DLCs and events and stuff like that. But instead of just the 2 years, I think it's probably going to be every 3 years from now on. And like Phil Spencer said, constant updates, live events and expansions to keep the game going. But pretty interesting to hear that perspective from the CEO of Xbox, that he's excited for Destiny 2 and anticipating it, and something I thought I'd discuss with you guys. So let me know your thoughts down below in the comment section. Of course, as always, if you enjoyed the video and a roundup of all the latest news, a like rating would be much appreciated. Stay tuned for many more videos on the channel, anything new that drops, I'll be sure to keep you guys updated, and I'll see you guys in the next one.